Welcome to Studio Biology. In this video, we are going to discuss the about of achenial fruits. Achenial fruits are single-seeded indehiscent type of fruits. So these are dry fruits of single-seeded indehiscent type. These fruit doesn't split on maturity, but the fruit wall disintegrates gradually or slowly to release the seed. The types are typical achene, caryopsis, cypsela, nut, and the simple samara. First of all, we'll discuss the typical achene. A typical achene develops from a monocarpillary pistil having superior unilocular ovary. It's important to note that the pericarp is attached to seed at only one point. The examples include Mirabilis jalapa, which is also known as 4 o'clock plant, Boiravia, Cosmos, etc. So here we can observe that the fruit is having a seed attached to the fruit wall at single point. This is the point of attachment and this is the single seed, while this is the outer pericarp. Here this is the point of attachment in Mirabilis jalapa. Now the second one is caryopsis. A caryopsis or grain is also a type of dry fruit, and it develops from monocarpillary pistil with superior unilocular and uniovulated ovary. It's important to note that the pericarp, which is thin and dry, is completely fused with testa or seed coat. The examples include the cereals, which are members of family Poaceae or Graminae, like Oryzae, that is rice, Triticum, that is wheat, and Zea, that is maize. So here this is the pericarp and this is completely fused with the seed coat or testa. Here is the root or radicle. Inside structure will be discussed later on. This is a cotyledon, endosperm, etc. So this is caryopsis or grain. Now the next one is the cypsela. Cypsela develops from a bicarpillary syncarpus, unilocular inferior ovary. The fruit wall is thin. This thin fruit wall develops from the pericarp and thalamus. Thalamus also participates and is attached to the seed at one point only. The examples include Helianthus, which is also known as sunflower, then marigold, sonchus, dandelion, etc. In sonchus or dandelion, Cypsela develops pappus for dispersal. So these are pappus for dispersal and this is the fruit. Now the next one is nut. A nut is having hard and woody fruit wall and it usually develops from multicarpillary syncarpus ovary. Let us discuss some examples. First one is Anacardium occidentale, that is cashew nut. Fruit is kidney shaped and it lies above the fleshy thalamus. This is the fleshy thalamus on which the fruit lies. Such fruit develops from monocarpillary superior ovary. So this is cashew nut. Next is oak. Oak is having a pericarp which is brown, hard and smooth, while it is surrounded by a capsule of bracts in basal part. This type of fruit develops from a tricarpillary syncarpus inferior ovary. So this is about oak. Next one is lychee chinensis. That is lychee. In lychee, pericarp is brown, spiny, hard, but brittle. This is the pericarp. It may be brownish or brownish red type. It develops from such fruit develops from a tricarpillary syncarpus trilocular ovary. Now this is having a single large brown seed. It is having single large brown seed. So this is about lychee. Juglans nigra, that is walnut. In walnut, this is the outer pericarp, which is husk-like. This one is endocarp. The shell is having the endocarp and is having two cotyledons of the seed. So these are the two cotyledons. This is having the outermost covering of endocarp. This is showing the outermost covering of endocarp. So this is walnut. Now the last type of achenial fruit is simple samara. Simple samara, the pericarp is winged. This is the pericarp and it is winged. These wings are basically the peripheral outgrowths or peripheral membranous outgrowths for dispersal. So we can observe that these are the wings which are helpful in dispersal, and this is the single seed. Example includes ulmus, holoptalia, which is also known as Indian elm, etc. It's important that if samaroid term is used, then it means that wings develop from other structures like sepals in case of shoria, that is sal. So this is simple samara. Another example is maple. So these are various types of achenial fruits. Thanks for watching this video.